Everybody, my name is David Pegler. This is your pre-London outlook for December the 30th. Almost at the end of the year, folks. Let me remind you the purpose of FXBOOTCAMP's education. That's not an alert service. Myself and none of the other currency coaches will make any trade recommendations during the course of a day, but what we will do is conduct some fundamental and technical analysis. Hopefully help you put together some decent trade plans for the day. Please remember, trading is always a very risky business, so do not trade real money until you have a good proven track record of success on a demo account. So, yesterday's little trade plan euro yen worked out quite nicely. I didn't get as deep a retracement as I wanted, but it became very evident. You'll notice that going into London, we had lower highs, but also no lower lows. So it was just a little continuation pattern at that point. And then a couple of ways to trade it is either take it directly off the 21 EMA, or grab the fib as she came back to retest. Or to make a little, this is actually a little 50% retracement, this little pullback here, a little 50% of the move. I was skeptical at the time. I told the boot campers in the room that, that's exactly where you'd want it to long it. The only problem is we had a correlation was all over the place. So the execution of it was a little bit trickier, but the actual trade worked out beautifully. So, no harm, no foul, a pretty good little trade plan. And I hope some folks got some value out of that, were able to capitalize on that a little bit. Now today, we might as well just keep moving forward to the same themes that we've had, for the last few days, and that's been a weak pound. And I'm talking pound Swissie and pound dollar. Now, do I think it's overdone? Absolutely. But am I going to call a bottom here? No. All I really want to be doing is just be trading for, just keep shorting at resistance. And taking profit where it makes, when and if it makes sense, and then going from there. And if we start reversing, I mean, you saw yesterday on the stock market, guys. There's no justification to see, essentially futures, the futures contract went like this yesterday without going to the chart. We went up during London, down during early New York trading, and then completely reversed again during late New York. I mean, it's just there's no justification for this other than buy low, sell high. So remain flexible in this market. I think that's really the biggest piece of advice I can give. And the one consistent theme we've had for the last few days, or last month, has been a weak pound. I'm talking euro pound, pound Swissie, pound dollar, pound Aussie, pound Kiwi, whatever you want to look at. It's all the same stuff. And I'm just still looking to sell at resistance. And where would that be? This is a pound dollar hourly chart, and you'll notice that we have a overlap between the 382 fib and the 21 EMA on the hourly. Guys, this is a perfect opportunity to try and get short somewhere in here with confirmation. I'm talking about confirmation. I like to use a 2-minute MACD or little 5A cross, or just price action myself. If we're stocking a little lower high at that point, well then I'm going to take a shot, with a stop above a 618 in this case. I know that's pretty far, but you just got to adjust your risk accordingly. And then you're looking for lower lows. Okay, it's really as simple as that. Now, if I think that this is overdone, however, if you just zoom out, you'll notice that we have broken some pretty key resistance area or pretty key support. These lows are about the only thing going. And if you just, we had a support zone here, I call it at 46, which has subsequently been broken. So, maybe if we pop up this little trend line here, might mean something. And that's ironically where prices stopped today. So, we're bouncing off a little bit of trend line support, but it's not the type of support they'd expect really to completely reverse price, but enough to give you a pullback, and that's actually what we're getting right now. So, not a problem. I think it's just a case of, down, bounce off support, back up to resistance, and then we're looking for lower lows. If we start to make, a 1-2-3 pattern or something, well, then we might see some short covering today, and that's a different trade plan altogether. Don't be close-minded to that. But I think that principally the trend has been down. We've seen a decent retracement here through Asia. You're looking to sell, folks, and continue selling. And the same thing if I take you to a pound Swissie chart. This is a 4-hour pound Swissie chart. Precipitous drop. Broke major support, intra-year support, and have subsequently fallen off the face of the earth. Now, is this overdone as well? Sure. Look at this divergence here on the 4-hour, right? very clear MACD divergence with an extremely overbought MACD, or oversold, I should say, MACD. Okay. Now, does that mean that you should be looking to get long? No. I mean, you don't want to be. You know, there's no need to get. There's no need to think that you should get long, just based on that. But don't be close-minded to the fact that we could see a 1-2-3 pattern or something on the 15-minute. Now, does that, you know, I'm not. I don't want to contradict myself, but does that mean I'm not looking to continue selling? Not at all. Absolutely, I am. And where is that likely to happen? How about the 53.50 area, hourly 21 EMA, plus a central pivot point? Seems like a golden opportunity, but. You know, guys, this is going to be well telegraphed on a 15-minute. We're going to probably go up, hit that hourly resistance, try to sell it, and then you'll start to see sort of a higher low situation and a break to the upside. Well, then I'd like a little fib pullback to go long. If you're really, really desperate to try and get long the pound, it makes me queasy just thinking about it. But, you know, you've got to be looking to sell that resistance and just continue these same themes that we've had. And, you know, selling around 53.50 just makes a whole lot of sense in the world. And we'll see if we get some good breaks down during the Asian session. And I know I'm just covering pound in general, yeah, pound dollar, pound Swissie. And if I just go to the pound yen, you know, I had this sort of trap yesterday going, and we've broken this as well. All right. And you'll notice that we're at our resistance area that we have been on all the other charts. And this is the same thing. You know, we might even see a retest all the way back to, say, 32, the figure, and then fall. Okay, but you still got to be bearish on pound until proven otherwise. You know, this one's a little different because you actually had a 1-2-3 pattern here, which gave you permission to think long. 1-2-3 being like this, a reversal pattern. 1-2-3. Okay, 5-8 cross, pull back. You know, a little 100 pips or whatever it is. So, you know, just stick with the same themes until proven otherwise here, guys. Look to short pound at resistance. Logical areas are the central pivots, 21 EMAs on the hourly. And until proven otherwise, that's what I'm going to be looking to do moving through the day. Although we sold off on Euro yesterday and a little bit on the Swiss franc, I expect those to be strong again today during the London session. It's just been the prevailing theme. I'm not going to break it. You know, I'm not going to go against it until proven otherwise here. Okay. I hope this was helpful. Quick little video today. Happy New Year to everybody. I'll catch up with you Friday. We've got a couple of days off here at Bootcamp. So good luck further today, folks. Don't try and deviate from the prevailing themes. There's just no need to. Okay. There's going to be plenty of pips trying to short these pounds where it makes sense. Okay. Good luck further, folks. Hope to see you in class sometime. See ya.